Jesus Church. Thank you for joining us for another amazing service.
Hello, Jesus Church. Welcome to another wonderful service. It's Easter weekend. I hope that you have been going to church and just enjoying the message of God. I believe that all of us are cleansed with the blood of Jesus. Just if you have not accepted Him, what are you waiting for? You need to accept Him. So we are here with another powerful service. But before we go anywhere with our service, can we just like go back, check our social media pages, just to see if we are subscribed to all of the things that you need to be subscribed for. We are on Instagram, we are on TikTok, we are on Facebook, obviously YouTube, we are also there. I mean, make sure that you are a subscriber. Click on the notification bell so that you can know what is happening in the life of the church. We are recording straight from Pretoria. We invite everyone every Sunday at 4 p.m. We are here in Pretoria. Just give us a WhatsApp. Or better yet, like just go to any of our inboxes. You will get answers. You get the location. Everyone is invited. You are invited. Come enjoy with us. It's a wonderful day. But before we get to anywhere, let's just go straight into worship.
There's nothing worth more than I'll ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're a living hope. Your presence, Lord. I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of love, when my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are there's nothing worth more that'll ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're a living hope. Your presence, Lord. I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of love, when my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. In your presence, Lord. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Oh, what a wonderful, wonderful worship, guys. Now we are about to go straight into the Word of God. I hope that you have your Bibles ready. I hope that you have a friend next to you, a family member next to you, your kids, your child, your spouse, someone next to you, because you cannot bear to listen to this thing alone. You need to share it because it's gonna be very, very powerful. I hope that you're expecting something from God with this word that's gonna be preached today. You know, it's one thing to just listen to another church service and be like, oh, okay, that's what God is saying today. But to be in expectance, like to expect something straight for you, not for only for the next person, just for you to expect something from God. I hope that you're doing that right now. And we're just gonna go straight into this powerful word of God without any waste of time. I'm ready. I'm already ready. I hope that you are ready too. Let's check this out.
Hello friends, I hope you're doing well. Guess what? My name is Robs, and I'm your friend. Hallelujah. One of my greatest and best days of the week is Sunday, because you know what? I love seeing people. I know that I'm excited that I'm gonna meet up with you friends, and that we're gonna have a great time in the presence of the Lord. When someone asked me this good question, is that, what's your greatest thing of doing ministry or doing church? And I said, is to see people on Sunday, and as well to get to release what God deposited in me during the week to preached it to us on Sunday. And can I tell you this, that when I preach, I don't only preach to you, I also preach to myself. So it's a self-reflection as well to me, that what I preach about here, it also speaks to me. Hallelujah. And I want to take this time to thank every person who's been faithfully in giving. And I can tell you this, we appreciate you. We see your efforts. You're giving throughout this trying times and challenging times that we're facing as a country, as a nation, as a continent. We just want to say thank you. Thank you very much. I mean, like, it is by you monthly, month to month, and as well sowing a seed so that we can able to buy lights, cameras, and you look good, and yeah, buy sound system. It is by or through your giving. Hallelujah. So we've been doing a sermon series, Deeper Word. I started off last week and I said, the Word of God creates. And what did I talk about? I talked about from the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 1, where God created the heavens and the earth, and he separated light from darkness, and he called light day, and he called dark night. Hallelujah. So this to show you that the power of how powerful God's word is, that he just spoke to an empty or a formless earth, and he said, let there be light, or created the heavens and the earth, and he said, let there be light, and there was light. Hallelujah. So to show you that there's so much, and God is of light, he said, let there be light. Hallelujah. So today we're talking about the Word of God gives direction. Ooh la la. The Word of God gives direction. Right there in the comment section, the Word of God gives direction. If you're sitting to someone, next to someone, tell them the Word of God gives direction. Hallelujah. And to show you that the Word of God gives direction. Let's go to the book of 1 Kings. 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 1. Now Elijah, the Tishbite from Tishbe, right, in Gilead, said to Ahab, as the Lord of Israel lives, whom I serve, there will be neither dew nor rain in the next few years except at my word. Let me repeat that. As the Lord of God, As the Lord God of Israel lives, whom I serve. Who's talking here? Elijah speaking. This is the God that I serve, and this is the God that I serve says that there'll neither be dew nor rain in the next few years except at my word. This is to show you that Elijah knew himself in Christ. The word of God cannot happen if there's an identical crisis. So Elijah knew himself in Christ. Who are you in Christ? I want you to take a reflection here and say, who am I in Christ? As I said, if you're sitting next to someone, rather don't say it to them. Say it to yourself, who am I? Hit yourself on the chest and say, who am I in Christ? Because I'll tell you why I'm saying that is because a lot of us have lost identical crisis in knowing ourselves in Christ. Because why? You don't believe what you say. And you don't believe in the word of God. You don't believe what you prayed for. Now, because of what you say, hardly happens because you don't know yourself in Christ. This is a man who knew himself in Christ. He said, I like what he said towards the end. He said, there'll neither be dew nor rain in the next few years except at whose word? Who gave him that word? God gave him the word and he said, except at my word. But he's saying it because he knew himself in Christ. And the Bible continues and says in verse 2, chapter 17, verse 2, 1 Kings 17, verse 2. Then the word of the Lord came to Elijah, leave here, turn eastward, and hide in the Kereth, ravine, east of Jordan. You will drink from the brook, and I've directed the ravens to supply you with food there. So if you don't have an identical crisis in Christ, and you believe in the word of God, and you believe that the word that God gave you at that point in time, and he gives you, because it gives you direction. And if he tells you to go east, go east. If he tells you to go west, go west. And you don't be disobedient to the word of God, you will lack nothing. You see, this is someone that God told him, said, do this. It came to him, just like the word that came to him, that there will neither be dew nor rain in the next few years, except at his word, at his word. So he did what the Lord had told him, and he went to Kereth Ravine, east of the Jordan, and he stayed there. And the Bible continues down. I've skipped some of the scriptures. Is that this is, as I said, this is someone that God has sent and God believed and trusted that if I send this one, he will do accordingly to what I tell him to do. And mind you, because of the relationship that Elijah had with God, a lot of things were able to happen because he knew himself in Christ. So said, who are you in Christ? Do you believe the word of God? As you read or study the word of God, do you believe what you're reading? Do you believe what you study? I had a conversation with a friend of mine, I think back in 2017 or 2018, I can't really remember. And he asked me, that what's the one thing that you are afraid of in doing in life? What scares you the most? I said to him, if I find myself, what scares me the most is finding myself disobeying the word of God, or rather disobeying God. A lot of times it has happened, a lot of times, but you come back and you, because of the conviction that is within you. because of the conviction that's within you, you come back and you correct yourself. They said in the previous sermon that the word of God gives direction. The word of God trains and corrects in righteousness. Who are you in Christ? Because if you know yourself in Christ, you are able to go according to the will of God and according to the direction of God. Let's go to the book of 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 19. The Bible says, and this, let me give you a bit of context what's happening here. This was when Elijah got the word from God that go to this woman and she'll give you food, she'll give you bread, she'll give you food. In some translations, Bible translation talks about it'll give you food or he'll give you bread. She'll give you bread, of which Elijah did, right? And he stayed at this woman's house on the upper room. The woman created, and before everything, the conversation that she had with Elijah is that this is the last meal that I have. And it's for me and my son. And after we've eaten this meal, that's the end of it. But she didn't realize, as long as she said, she knew who Elijah was. But she didn't realize that the power of Elijah and the anointing that Elijah had is that Elijah got a word from God to that, go to this, you'll meet a certain woman and she'll give you food to eat. Elijah gave the woman the word that fill up these, fill up these buckets, of which the woman did. And then there was an overflow of what she had expected. And I like what she said is that, as the Lord commands, and as the Lord lives, I shall do what the Lord says. You see, the obedience that the woman had of what God told Elijah to do, and what Elijah told the woman to do. So, in 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 19, the Bible says, and this was when the woman's son had passed on. Elijah said, "Give me your son." He took him from her arms, carried him to the upper room where he was staying, and he laid him on his bed. Then he cried out to the Lord, "Lord, my God, have you brought tragedy even on this widow I'm staying with by causing her son to die?" He then stretched himself out on the boy three times and he cried out to the Lord, "Lord, my God, let this boy's life return to him." If you remember, in our last week, I said that the word of God heals and the word of God brings back the dead to life. Elijah stretched himself out on this boy three times and he cried out to the Lord, "Lord, my God, let this boy's life return to him." The Lord heard Elijah's cry and the boy's life returned back to him and he lived. Elijah picked up the child and he carried him down from the room into the house. He gave him to his mother and said, "Look, your son is alive." Then the woman said to Elijah, "Now that I know you are a man of God, and that the word of the Lord from your mouth is truth." Wait a minute. Did you not believe that God has sent me to you? That even after the word I gave you to do, you still do not believe me? Are you only believing me now? When your child is alive from death? You see, that's the problem that we have. That we don't believe what God says. God has created the heavens. God has healed, has brought the dead to life. But still, we don't believe him. We don't. Our foundation is not firm. Imagine the house that you're living in now. If the foundation of the house that you're living now, of any building, if it was not as strong that the wind, when it blows, that the building will crash down. So that means that according to what I'm reading and getting here, that the woman did not believe on, did not believe every word that Elijah had said. Of which at times we can think that we believe it, but we don't actually believe it until something happens. You see, something happened that was close to her, that her son passed on. And she says to God, and she cries out to God, God, why have you brought tragedy in the woman's life? Then the woman said to Elijah, now I know that you are men of God, and that the word of the Lord from your mouth is the truth. So should I bring back the dead to life so that you can be convinced that I'm the true God? Then this is to show you, friends, that the word of God does indeed give direction. The word of God heals. The word of God brings the dead to life. Whose word are you believing? Whose word are you believing? John 1 verse 1 to 6, the Bible says, and I'll be closing up. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. He was with God in the beginning. That means that the word of God, he is himself the word, and that the word was with him. And the word was with him in the beginning. That's why he was able to create the heavens and the earth, separate light and darkness. Through him, all things were made, which were created. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. Through him, all things were made. Through him, everything was created. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. So if we do not have God, that means that we won't be here right now. And in him, everything was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light that shines in the darkness, and the darkness that has not overcome it. So darkness cannot overcome the light. The light overcomes the darkness. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning the light, so that through him all might believe. Himself was not the light. He came only as a witness of light. Where you at now, friends? Are you coming in as a witness of light? Are you coming as a word that you speak right now, but you don't yet believe it? 90% of us, we go to church on a Sunday, but we hardly believe the word that the preacher preaches. God gave a word. God gave a command. God gave a direction. That do this. Do that. Don't do this. Do that. Go this way. Don't go that way. But because we are disobedient to the word of God. I want to leave you with this question. Who are you in Christ? Who are you in Christ? I want to become a friend of God that obeys the word of God, that believes in the word of God. and speak what God has given me and never be in disbelief of the word of God. We leave you with that question. Who are you in Christ? Let's go find our identity in Christ. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. Thank you for this day. For this is the day that you've made, that we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you for your word that you've given us today, Lord. We honor you. We give all the praise. For you are good, Lord. Help us to put the word that you gave to us this evening into action. Help us to believe the word, even when we study the word, your Bible, the word that you gave us. We want to become like the Elijahs of the world. We want to become the Jeremiahs of the world, the Daniels of the world, the Jobs of the world. We thank you, Father God. In this we pray, in your wonderful and precious name. That as we go into a new week, Lord Jehovah, that be with us, Lord. So many of us who are believing you for jobs, business opportunities, believing you for marriages, believing you for promotions in our works, on our workspaces. We thank you, Lord. And we believe, Father God, we thank you that you're yet getting into a season of seeing that our prayers are manifesting, that your blessings are manifesting this season, Lord. We thank you. In your wonderful name, we pray. In Jesus' name, we pray. Let the people of God say, amen and amen. Well, friends, thank you very much for joining us. We love you so much. Do get in touch with us. I want to hear. I want to receive your message. I want you to let us know how we can pray with you, how we can best be there for you. Do not miss our next sermon series. I'm excited. Still here to preach. And we believe in God for this great new season. I love you. We love you. We're all about people knowing Jesus and making friends. Cheers, guys.
Oh yes, what another powerful, I promised you guys, it was going to be powerful. We don't do mediocre yet. We do it, another powerful word. I hope that you just grab these words of our, run with them, because, you know, if I can tell you one thing about my life is that ever since I started listening to Jesus Church, ever since I just got committed to this thing, there's something different in my life. Like, changes automatically, whether it's faith, whether it's spiritually, whether it's physically. I'm telling you guys, it makes you a better person. So invite other people as well. There are many people struggling out there. They don't have anyone to talk to. They are not open yet to talk to someone else. But through listening to such words, people's lives are changed. So please guys, make sure that you share these messages. And right now we are just about to go to the word of offering, and just I'm encouraging you guys to give. And the scripture that we're going to be looking at today, I'm not going to mention it. I just want you to go and search it, because I know it's a very, very powerful scripture that most of Christians know, but I want you to go and research it yourself. So the scripture, it comes in where there are 5,000 people who needed food from Christ. And Jesus was just there, and the disciples were like, okay, Jesus, people want food. Like, how can we help them? And Jesus goes back to them and he says that, what do you have? So that's the question that we have to ask ourselves today, because Jesus wants to know, what do you have, so that he can feed you. Jesus wants to know, what exactly do you have, so that he can supply your needs. He needs you to be in the position of giving so that he can be in a position, so that you can be in a position of receiving. So that's how it works. That's the principle that Jesus was teaching them, that if you have something, give it to me. I will multiply it and give it to you. And we are not just giving to God for his own benefit. Jesus, in fact, when everyone was fed and the disciples took their bread and whatever is so left, Jesus was left with anything. He had to go and do things by himself. It's not just us giving to God for his own benefit. We are giving to God for our own benefit. Can we just pray for the offering? Father, we thank you, Holy Spirit, Moranaka. We believe, Father Lord, the seeds that we have given, Holy Spirit, are a process for us to receive from you in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that we are capable and we are able, Holy Spirit, Moranaka, to be in this position of giving in the name of Jesus. We pray, Father Lord, in thanksgiving. Amen and amen. Thank you, guys, man. This was amazing. So if you want to see more of this, go back to our page, just view what you missed. And if you didn't miss anything, wait for us. We are here next week, same time, same place. Bye.